Welcome to my channel. I'm ball sports lover, Dr. NBA. Today, I'll be talking about basketball. There are 30 teams in the world-class league called the NBA, where players show amazing performances every year. Teams trade and replace players to make a winning team, and players move to other teams to benefit their playtime. For a player to stay on one team is pretty uncommon. However, there are cases where the team picks a player that is highly skilled to lead the team's future, known as franchise stars. For example, Kobe Bryant, Stephen Curry, Michael Jordan, Yao Ming, etc. In today's video, we will be talking about one of the legends out of all the franchise players, Dirk Nowitzki, an unstoppable force that was known for his one-legged fadeaway shot. We'll get into how Nowitzki took over the NBA and how big of a deal he actually was in this video. 1978 Würzburg, Germany. Basketball player for her mother, national team handball player for her father, Nowitzki was born. And it was no surprise he was playing sports at an early age. But out of all the sports, tennis was his go-to sport. But at the age of 13, Nowitzki was much taller than his fellow classmates and was growing at a rate where he had already passed his teacher's height. And that's when he decided to play basketball and joined the city team called DJK Würzburg, where he met a coach that would go with him for his whole life, Holger Geschwinder. Holger was known to be a tough coach and taught Nowitzki how to shoot and pass with much detail. But basketball wasn't all he taught. Holger had made him study basic manners and learn to play instruments in band. Due to his coaching method, Nowitzki had more to offer than just basketball. He had many traits such as great manner and great personality, which made the fans love him even more. As time went by, Holger was coaching a young Nowitzki, and the time had come where Nowitzki had to choose his path. Holger had asked him to decide whether he wanted to become a global basketball star or be satisfied with being the best in his country. And Nowitzki's answer was a global star. Moving forward, Nowitzki was growing more skilled with Holger's coaching ability and left a youth-level team and joined the adult league. He was only 16 when he joined that league. At age 17, Nowitzki was on the starting lineup, playing to the fullest. His team was in the second division, and he had only one goal, to lead his team to the first division. His play on the court was quite impressive, and his ability to shoot with his height and physical strength helped him, a teenager facing players that were full-grown adults. As a result, his mid-ranked team from last year came second in the regular season and had a chance to make it to the top division in just one more game. But unfortunately, they lost that game and remained in the second division. And in the following year, Nowitzki had an average of close to 20 points per game, but still failed in making it to the top division. And so, his final chance in the 97-98 season had started. However, Nowitzki had to serve time in the army for 10 whole months at the age of 19. But thankfully, it was allowed to serve time separately for the army, and athletes were allowed to play a certain amount of games. And Nowitzki, even though he was technically a soldier in the army, still played 20 games out of 40, and really bared down in every game, averaging 28.3 points per game, making him the scoring leader, which helped the team advance to the top division successfully. After that, Nowitzki was named German Basketball Player of the Year, and Nike was holding an exhibition game for top prospects for each country versus prospects in the US. And in that game, Nowitzki put up 33 points and 14 rebounds that shook all the NBA scouts. Now Nowitzki wasn't just known in Germany, but was known to be a prospect globally. Unfortunately enough, his time as a soldier in the German army had just ended, and with the spotlight of the media, he had entered the 1998 NBA draft. And so Nowitzki was drafted 9th out of 58 players to the Milwaukee Bucks, but at the same time was traded with the 6th pick for Dallas and had moved teams. To clear things up, there was a three-way trade in the process. The Dallas Mavericks had their eye on Nowitzki and Steve Nash from the Phoenix Suns and had successfully obtained both prospects. Then it was settled. Nowitzki was now responsible for the future of the Dallas Mavericks and was able to keep his word that he had made with his former coach Holger on entering the highest level of basketball globally. Nowitzki's first season in the 98-99 had started. And because it was his dream come true to play in the top class, he had a lot going on in his head on how to play on the court. Halfway past his first season as a starting power forward, his performance was absolutely terrible. Compared to his former German league, the NBA big men were much stronger and skilled in the paint zone. And the tempo of the game was pretty much a cultural shock for Nowitzki. It wasn't just defense that he was struggling with. His offense was also doing poorly, and his three-pointers were at a low 20%. In frustration, Nowitzki thought of giving up his dream and heading back to Germany. However, he pulled himself together and spent time practicing more than ever. Forgetting about that year and coming into the next season, Nowitzki had a different mindset. He was calmer and adapted to the Mavericks' game plan. From the same 98 draft, Steve Nash and captain Michael Finley worked together with Nowitzki to run the offensive show. Due to that, Nowitzki's average went from 8.2 points per game in his rookie season to 17.5 in his second season, doubling his average. In the midst of all that, Mark Cuban came in the middle of the season as a new owner and invested in marketing and building a new training facility so the players could focus on basketball alone. Thanks to Mark, the Mavericks were able to come ninth in the Western Conference and was making progress to get closer to the playoffs. And in Nowitzki's third year in, they came fifth in the Western Conference, going 53 wins and 29 losses, finally making their way to the playoffs. And Dirk Nowitzki had gradually become the scoring leader of the Mavericks and was on his way to the first round of the playoffs against the Utah Jazz. And maybe because it was his first time in the playoffs, Utah took the first two games. But in the third game, which was at home, Nowitzki started to play his game, being in good position, shooting and driving the ball. He shot 33 points twice and led the Mavericks into defeating the Utah Jazz in the first round. And so, the Spurs were next in round two, and after a hard fight, Nowitzki had a record-breaking 42 points in a single game, but lost the round completely due to the solid defense of the Spurs. Even though it was a disappointing playoff run, Nowitzki grew from that experience, and 2 years later, had a season average of 25.1 points per game, making it to the playoffs where he would get his rematch against the Spurs. 5 years in, 02-03 season, Nowitzki's hair and beard have grown, now looking like a veteran. His physical strength and game sense have improved, and he was on top of his game. At 7 feet, his jump shot for his two-pointers and three-pointers were too precise and accurate. And at that height, it was not easy for players to guard him. And when players double-teamed him, Nowitzki knew when to thread the needle and always pass to an open area for the assist, or would use his fast speed and dribbling to drive all the way to the rim for the point. As the go-to guy, he led the team having a record of 60 wins and 22 losses, coming third in the Western Conference. In the playoffs, they won the first round, second round, and for the first time made his way to the Western Conference Finals. And of course, the opposition would be the Spurs. The rematch Nowitzki had waited for 2 years, had finally come. Nowitzki, now in his best condition, scored an unbelievable 38 points, helping the Mavericks take game one for the win. Starting the round off with good rhythm, the Dallas Mavericks would have to face an inescapable bad luck's fate. That fate would be the injury of point leader Dirk Nowitzki. After blocking a shot, he fell uncomfortably, injuring his leg, and his condition was too serious for him to continue playing. Nowitzki had to watch in depression as his team would lose once again to the Spurs. After that, for the following 2 years, Nowitzki would lead the Mavericks in the top standings in the regular season, but unfortunately would fall in the playoffs every time. It's his eighth year on the Mavericks, and heading into the 05-06 season, his trio of Steve Nash and Michael Finley was no more. They have branched off into different teams. So now, Nowitzki would have to lead his team and play every game with only one goal in becoming the NBA champions. With the responsibility of the team's future, Nowitzki played any role on the court that was necessary and played more wisely but aggressively, making his jump shots even more flawless, shooting a career high of 26.6 points per game, leading the team into the fourth spot in the Western Conference, having 60 wins and 22 losses, getting yet another chance to win the playoffs. They won the first round with ease, going 4-0, and made their way to the second round. And awaiting them, the team that felt undefeatable were the San Antonio Spurs. But this time, Nowitzki was not planning on losing. He played through the Spurs' solid defense, scoring relentlessly and carrying his team to victory. After 4 games, the Mavericks were winning 3-1 and had the advantage. But the Spurs had won the next 2 games, winning each game with the slightest score difference and pushing it to the 7th round. The 7th game would be an away game, so the pressure was high for Dallas, but Nowitzki took the challenge and was shooting on point. After the first 2 quarters, the Mavericks were 20 points ahead, but the Spurs were not ready to give up yet, and through relentless offense, tied the game up. It didn't stop there. They turned the game around, and the Spurs were on top. With only 32 seconds left in the game, the owner, the biggest fan of the Dallas Mavericks' face, was all serious, thinking they might lose again to the Spurs, but Nowitzki stepped up using a spin move, getting the layup and one. tying the game up, taking the Spurs to overtime, where they picked up the pace and finally for the first time defeated the Spurs, and were heading to the third round. After that dramatic round against the Spurs, Nowitzki led their team to victory in the third round, winning 4-2, and were finally the Western champions. Now it was the champions of the West and East, going at it in the NBA Finals. There, they would face Dwayne Wade and Shaquille O'Neal, leading the Miami Heat. For the first time being in the NBA Finals, Nowitzki would play a calm and precise game, winning both home games, leading the series 2-0. Dallas was starting to feel like they might actually become the champions, and headed off to Miami to play the next game. But all that excitement changed, losing 4 consecutive games and left humiliated. The reason behind this humiliating comeback was not because the Heat were too skilled, but because of the referee's terrible calls. The calls that were made completely against the Mavericks, and whenever Miami Heat's Dwayne Wade would drive the ball, the smallest contact would be called as a foul, sometimes without even any contact. And the referee would hold that whistle, waiting for the smallest touch to be made by Mavericks player so another foul could be called. Using this to his advantage, Dwayne Wade dived numerously in every contact made, and in the 6 games that were played, there were 97 free throws given to him. This would be an important factor for the Mavericks' loss, because they had only lost by 1-3 points every game. The 2006 NBA Finals were too lopsided, and even the fans of Miami thought the games were rigged. And just like that, the hopes of Nowitzki and the fans of the Mavericks were shattered, and becoming the NBA champions felt like another long-lost dream. And after that, for a long 4 years, Nowitzki and various young prospects would be stopped by the forever-lasting rival, San Antonio Spurs, and would not be able to go past the second round of the playoffs. And after 13 years in the Mavericks, heading into the 10-11 season, Nowitzki is now 32 years old. For all the fans, teammates, and the people associated with the Mavericks, Nowitzki would not be able to lead the team to victory, leaving him with an even more heavier conscience each and every day.